We live in a country and a state that have been richly blessed. We live in a country where democracy is not just a good idea, but a way of life. In the United States, we can freely practice our religion and values. Freedom, economic opportunity, and prosperity are a reality in our country. Our nation is one filled with great hope and promise. At the same time, we are a nation of great contrasts. We are a nation that believes in peace, but is living through a war. A nation of immigrants, but facing tremendous challenges that divide our society. A nation of great family traditions, yet many question the value of traditional marriage. A nation with great economic prosperity, and still there are many who live in poverty. We are a nation founded on Christian values and principles, yet the most vulnerable members of our society, especially the unborn, are not protected.
The Catholic Church certainly understands and also believes in the separation of church and state, but that doesn't mean we believe in the separation of faith and politics. Faith is what drives the thinking of Catholics, of Christians, in terms of their relationship with God, but also in terms of their relationship with their neighbor. And because of that, our political relationships, which are about our relationships with our neighbor, are informed by our faith. And so serious Catholics, whether they're politicians or ordinary voters, have a obligation, actually, to make sure that faith informs their political decisions and their actions. So I hope that all of us in the church understand this and are not afraid to be women and men of faith in the public square, because that's where Christ wants us to be in the great issues of our day.
We Catholics are not one-issue voters, but neither do we Catholics believe that every issue is of the same moral weight or value. All of the many issues and rights about which we are so rightfully concerned are grounded in that fundamental right, which our Declaration of Independence calls unalienable, and that is the right to life. Pope John Paul II, in Christi Fidelis Laici, taught us that the common outcry of people on behalf of so many human rights is finally false and illusory if the fundamental right, the right to life, is not defended with the utmost determination.
The Catholic bishops are calling our Catholic people to political responsibility. We are asked questions about decisions to be made politically and socially. We are called as bishops then to help the people to form a good conscience, to make good decisions, because we are asked to make very serious decisions in the political realm, in the social realm. Therefore, we need to form a good conscience. And to form a good conscience, we must follow the teachings of Jesus Christ. And in following the teachings of Jesus Christ, to the church, we are led to make good and just and right decisions. This is important for us, for all of us to know. Now, in our political realm, many decisions will be made. All our decisions, issues are not equal. Some decisions, in not being equal, we have to look, because sometimes those decisions can be intrinsically evil, and we cannot accept that. So, my brothers and sisters, today we ask our Catholic people to follow the teachings of the Catholic Church as led by the Church, so that we can make those properly decisions. Now we have great opportunity, to help people to vote properly and to make decisions that will bring peace, that will bring justice and good to the life of the Church and the life of the people. So I ask you to be responsive to this and to respond to the call of the bishops. Look at your life, look at the decisions that have to be made, and then, under the guidance of a good conscience, you'll be able to make those important, just and right decisions for the protection of life and for the dignity and sanctity of human life.
You can make a difference. Make your voice heard during this upcoming election in support of religious freedom, dignity for human life, and justice and peace for all peoples. There are many resources and information available to guide your thinking on these topics. Visit the Colorado Catholic Conference's website at www.cocatholicconference.org. God has given us a great nation and a great state to call home. Your vote is important, and your participation is vital and necessary. This country will not be a good place for any of us to live in unless we make it a good place for all of us to live in. Theodore Roosevelt. We as Catholic faithful must make a commitment to take action. Our action makes a difference in the lives of our families, the future of our children, their education, the pursuit of justice for immigrants, the dignity of all human life, and in our commitment to help our brothers and sisters who are most in need. Let us go out and make our voices heard this election season and vote.